What's going on today, FG fam? Today, I break my silence. I've stood by and watched a lot of Twitter talk and some Twitter beef between creators in the Madden community and the franchise community as a whole. The Madden 21 launch came in and separated everyone into factions for some reason. Where do I stand? Make sure you drop a like on this video and subscribe if you're like me at all. All franchise mode all the time. It's all we do here on this channel, and I know you'd enjoy it, so join the Discord if you want to connect with me more. Most of the people from the Discord know some of the things I'm about to say because they've really gotten to know me. And the link is in the description below if you want to join yourself. I'm going to be talking about both of the community hashtags that have trended on Twitter recently. I will not call anyone out or mention any other creators. This is purely my thoughts on what has transpired and my feelings about how things should be handled. Let's start off with hashtag fix Madden franchise. I love this movement and this concept, and EA seemed to take notice of it with some promises for the future. With so many features missing that used to be in the game, such as restricted free agency, mini camps, assistant coaches, create a team, and more, the game has undergone two eras of mediocrity. Since the switch to PS3 and Xbox 360, Madden has seen a shift from one of the most innovative sports games to one of the most mundane. However, Madden is taking all the heat for perhaps being the first one to do that, but let's not take the spotlight off of other sports games. As every sports game moves towards microtransactions, NBA 2K creators complain about their game year in and year out. I will admit that my league does offer more to users than Madden's franchise, but the gameplay at times is just bad. MLB The Show is one of my favorite sports games on the market, and even one of their additions this year was a half-assed relocation and rebranding feature that had no create a stadium, and it left you in the original team stadium or a minor league stadium, which made no sense. So it seems like most games don't really think their new features through when they do create some. NHL has things that I wish EA would put into Madden, such as Fog of War, but one thing they don't have that Madden does is the ability to control multiple teams, or even the whole league if you wanted to, in your franchise mode. Every sports game has their issues. I definitely want Madden to be better and go back to being the beast of sports gaming that it used to be. Can we get them there? I think we can, and I'll tell you how soon. First, let's discuss the other hashtag that has hit trending. It was trending at number 3 last night and sparked multiple news websites like Fox News and Sports Illustrated to write articles on it. Hashtag NFL Drop EA. While I definitely agree that EA needs competition to fuel their game, as all sports games do, the NFL will likely never drop EA from the exclusivity agreement. These are two multi-billion dollar organizations that are very much in bed with each other. And they want each other. They're not going to let each other go. The other thing is, the NFL license is, out of all sports, the one that costs the most. It's hard for many to purchase it anyway. 2K now has it for non-simulation games, and that's likely the only other big company conglomerate who could afford it at this time. The NFL is as much of a giant bully as EA can be, and they both only really care about their wallets right now. The issue for franchise gamers like you and I is that they're gonna get that money regardless of how. For that reason, the immediate reaction from gamers and creators is boycotting the game and hitting their wallet where it hurts. Now that would make sense, wouldn't it? But it's also the reaction people have on how to get them to fix franchise mode. Just boycott the game until they do it. Well, you'd be waiting a really long time. Let me tell you how to get this movement accelerated. Viewers, talking to you. Play franchise mode. Play it a lot. Don't really play any other modes. If you're a younger viewer, have your friends come over, play franchise mode with them, play an online franchise with your friends. Don't play Mutt KO in the yard as much if you truly care more about franchise. You have to play that mode the most. If you're an older viewer, show your kids and nephews how to have their own fun in franchise mode. Heck, play it with them like my dad used to do with me. Don't angrily tweet and harass the developers. It's really not their fault. Most of them truly do care about the game and the direction of it and started working for EA to try to make some change, only to find out that they really have no voice at the company. Creators, your turn. Make franchise content. Show off your artistry. The game is mundane, but that doesn't mean you have to make mundane content. Show how you have fun in franchise mode, even if the mode doesn't have awesome features. Now, Madden has never had a halftime show. In fact, the only NFL game that did was ESPN NFL 2K5. Well, this year in my Madden 21 Rams franchise, I have a halftime show that I cut up and produce myself with the help of my friend Adam, who creates the graphics. Just because Madden doesn't serve it up on a silver platter doesn't mean you can't create something. If you have ideas that are awesome, peacefully contact developers via email or Twitter DM with your great ways to improve the game. Being a content creator is similar to being an artist. We take game footage and turn our final product into a great piece of art. Now use your art the right way. I know it's easier to boycott, but it's really not going to do anything to help franchise mode. Instead, it will further tilt the scale of the most popular modes in the game and help those modes take over. Mutt, and now The Yard, are going to be overplayed by younger audiences. To make EA care about the mode, it needs to be played more like it was in the old days, to show that there is a wide range of people that are interested in franchise mode and want it fixed properly. Boycotting will just take away all of us franchise mode players, and leave EA with all Mutt, KO, and Yard players. And you know what that's gonna do? It's gonna make EA happy. You know why? They no longer have to hear from us, because we won't be playing the game, and instead they're gonna get those people that are playing Mutt and KO and the Yard fueling their wallets for years to come. I know more than just the youth play Mutt, but it is a dangerous slope. Microtransactions easily manipulate children from a marketing standpoint. Take Fortnite, for instance. I once came across a lady at GameStop who found out for the first time that Fortnite was actually a free game. She'd been paying near $100 per month on the game for her son. Now sure, you could chalk that up to a dumb parent if you want to, but it doesn't stop the kid from wanting the product for the rest of his life. Same's gonna happen with Madden. This is why we need to show today's youth the value of franchise mode and all the fun that can be had in the mode building teams and creating storylines amongst the league. A bunch of angry middle-aged men complaining about the game they grew up playing is not going to invoke change. Promoting change in the culture of the game and the modes that get played and by what demographic they get played by is what's going to set things in the right direction. EA knows that if they improve franchise mode, it's not going to appeal to the youth. And they're the people that are mostly playing the game right now and what EA wants to market towards. Think about the cigarette industry. It doesn't matter if it's a good or a bad product. You want to get kids on it, and you want to start them young. And that's what EA is trying to do with Mutt and microtransactions. 2K's been doing this as well. EA is not alone. I've loved playing franchise mode since I was just a little boy. I remember Madden 2003 being the game I would play with my dad every single day I came home from school. All of my loyal followers know that I always say the golden age of Madden was from Madden 2003 to 2007, all on PS2 for me personally. But it is indeed possible, and in my opinion necessary, to agree with and support the movement of hashtag FixMaddenFranchise and hashtag NFLDropEA without actually using hatred and wanting to boycott the game. I will continue playing franchise modes because here's an analogy for you. I could be given a box of crayons that does not include every color, but I can still make the colors that I need. EA right now is not giving us a full box of crayons, but I know you as content creators and myself included, we can make all the colors that we need to make a beautiful painting. Go out and spread some positivity today, instead of all the negativity that I've seen lately. I hope you all enjoy your day today, and if you are having a bad day, I'm really sorry to hear that, and it will get better. Check out some franchise content right here to cheer you up right now. I feel you, thanks somehow.